Hello guys, welcome back. This is Ravi. You're watching RSP Gameverse Witcher 3 Wild Hunt gameplay. At the end of the last episode, we did take care of two contracts, and today we are gonna take care of some of the miscellaneous quests before we even proceed with the main quest to go to Skellige. That will be pushed aside for a while. So we have first, I'm gonna take care of the Gwent with Vernon Roach. So
thanks for everything.
Thanks for everything. What did I do? Oh, probably killing that monster. Okay, fine. So I'm gonna go and meet Vernon Roach to play Gwent. Alright, let's go and speak to Vernon Roach and take care of Gwent. Because I'm going to take care of the Gwent special Gwent games with at least in the Novigrad area. I don't make false moves with friends, buddy. Thank you very much. I'm not as drunk as you are, jackass.
Geralt of Rivia, safe and sound.
Yep, care for a round of Gwent. I know that he investigated Geralt in Witcher 2, but I didn't play the game. I just played about
Roach.
First 15 or 20 minutes.
Play against you. If you've got a deck, pull it out.
Yep, let's play.
Good luck.
Good luck. Yeah, it's supposed to be fun, buddy. Just show some emotions. I understand you are Geralt, who doesn't have any emotions because of your mutations, but yeah, at least try to show some enthusiasm. It's been a while since I played the game. I have to remember my cards. Oh, not bad deck at all. That is it. I think I can. Maybe I can just. Oh, wow. Perfect. I wouldn't have asked for a better replacement than that. Oh, and a. Wow. Superb cards. My turn. Okay, let's start with this. Okay, not bad. Not bad at all. Should I let me pass. Should I pass or should I maybe I'll play Vernon Roach against Vernon Roach and see how he reacts. Yeah, let me play Vernon Roach against Vernon Roach. Okay, then I will pass this round if he doesn't want to continue. Okay, I'm gonna pass this round. Maybe he has a decoy that he plays to get back his pie card and then use it against me, but that's totally fine. That's totally. Oh, he doesn't. Okay, good. Oh my god. Okay, what else do I have? Nothing else. So I have to start playing the big guns. So I'll probably have to play this. I don't think I have an option now. Because nothing else is gonna. Jesus Christ, buddy. So I don't think I have a choice. I have to play these two cards. But the problem is that they're gonna double it and then I wasted my 32. Well, fine. Fine. I don't think I have. Oh my god. Yeah. I should have used my commander's horn to double the last row. That was a bad move, alright. Okay, fine. Fine, fine, fine. I still have decoys, so I can get back my two big cards using two decoys. Your turn. So I'm gonna actually start playing. I'm just gonna use this throwaway card because I don't think I have any cards to play. Well, I don't think I have any other rows to use that. Good. Good, 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 good. So that should be fine. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna play this and bring back one of my catapults. Okay, good deal, good deal. I also need Triss Marigold. So then, now I'm gonna play this. Oh, wait. Okay, I'm gonna play this. Alright, I'm gonna play this. I'm not gonna double this until it's too late, because he may have a scorch cut that could destroy my... Okay. So... Yeah. I'm gonna have to play this. But the problem is, if he has a scorch card, I'm doomed. He'll destroy my 32 cards. Yeah. Please don't play scorch card. Doubles the siege unit. Oh! Fine. He's also using the same... Do I have any other cards to use? Nope. I guess I don't have a choice but to play this. I really don't have any other choice, right? Unless he plays a spy card against me. Yeah, I don't think I have any decent cards to play, except I have to keep playing the same card over and over again, because that's all I have. I'm not gonna use my decoy, my healer card, to bring back any cards, because it's a super, it's a hero card, special card. I guess, yep. And I have to use this again to continue the game. Clear weather. Yep. Let me play this again and extend his gameplay. See, I don't think I have any. Now he's gonna, stupid idiot, gonna play the spy card. Oh my god. Oh, okay, fine. Fine, I think he's done, right? Passed. Okay, I won the game. I won the game. Not bad. Not bad at all. I won the game. Yeah, like I said, if you have two decoys, two healers in the first round itself, then I don't think there's any opponent that can...
You won. Congratulations. Here, you earned the card.
Know anyone else worth playing?
I've heard of a man came through Novigrad recently. He might be interested to know he's also a Witcher. Lambert, they call him.
I know Lambert. Had no idea he played Gwent, though.
Not the only acquaintance you can challenge. Tala's a keen gambler and has a sharp deck. He's in the area. You might try him.
Ah, okay. Lambert has to wait because he's gone to... He may have gone to Tetragor to take care of that quest, right? That stupid piece of quest that spawns across areas. Now we're going to go to Tallar. No, wait a minute. Where is it showing? It says nearby. Okay, so it's gonna spawn me to a world map. Where is he? Oh yeah, he's in Kaer Morhen. All right. So the Kaer Morhen, as you can see, is not yet open. So we will go to Kaer Morhen at some point, but right now we are not going there yet. That's Witcher's hideout or Witcher's fort. We're not going there anyway. So assuming that Lambert is waiting there, we're gonna have to win the card from Tallar. I'll fast travel to where he is and then we'll meet. We'll see you on the other side. Alright, there you go. We are here to meet Tallar, who appears to be inside this cavern. So let's go and speak to... Alright, shut up, whoever that was. Oh, Tallar! Yep, let's play the game, buddy. I want to finish this game until we meet Game of Gwent. Yep.
Did I hear right? Word is you like to play cards.
I like to play, period. Dice, cards, chess. I unwind playing games. You asking because you got fuck all to talk about? Or are you in the mood for a round?
Let's play.
All right, let's play. Just remember, only interested in good cards. Don't want any trash.
Don't want any trash. Okay, what was the card that we got? I think that was some other Redanian, probably Redanian deck. Okay, let's get started. I need Geralt and I need Trish left to collect, if I'm not mistaken. So, okay. Oh, not bad game at all, but this one needs to go, and a decoy, which is good, and you also need to go. Oh my god, I got good, decent cards. Venom Roach, all super cards, special cards. Okay. give me two decent cards, please. Okay, not bad. Two decoys, which is very good. All ranged. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna play this. And then if he's gonna play another ranged card, which is 10, maybe I can use my Scorch to eliminate that. That would lower his score to 13. I still am lagging, right? So no, let me, you know what? Let me pass the game. I'm gonna use my best cards in the last two rounds. Hopefully I win this game. If not, then I'll have to do that all over again, and I'll probably edit the game for you guys so that you don't have to watch me stumble. See, Geralt. Well, I can play Ciri. I don't think I have Geralt in my deck. That's something I need to find quickly. And I guess opponent has passed. So if we draw, I'm gonna lose. So I will have to play a card. Oh my god. Because if I draw, I don't know whether draw... It's Nilfgaardian deck that will win you draws, but not the Northern Realms. So I don't think I have a choice but to play that card. Now give me a decent card, maybe a healer, please, game. Nope. You're stupid. You know that game? You're stupid. So to start off, I'm gonna use this. Oh my god. Okay. So should I use this one right away or just wait? Maybe, yeah, I'm gonna wait. Probably wait, because at this moment it's only 8. It's only 8, so okay. Fine. That's totally okay. The problem is I don't have decent cards. I only have 3 more. Oh, he's gonna play healer. Spy card, please. Thank you very much. Perfect. So why don't I quickly immediately get that spy back? Because I wanna use the best cards as early as possible. Okay. Now, give me something. Good card, please. Okay, not bad. Not bad at all. Yeah, that's fine. That's totally okay. I'm down with that. Let's start with this. And then next one, I'm gonna play this. So he has 7, 7, 10, and 1. 10. I still need to use this at some point to kick his butt. 6. Why don't I use that now? Wait a minute, I can use this. Yeah, let me use this now. Yep. He has only 2 more cards left. Oh, and he's cleared the weather. Why? I mean, I understand, but why? Let me play this then. Yeah. If he has a Scorch card, he's gonna lower my score. Oh, I won actually. At this point, I won. But let me for the sake of extending the game, let me bump up my score. Wow, all the way to 96. I won. Okay, I think my deck seems to be in a good condition at this point. There's only one guy who gave me so much trouble after 7th attempt.
Know how long it took me to assemble that plowing deck?
Nope. Hey, know any other players who are good? And what's more, have good cards?
Been hearing a lot of late about some prick named Lambert. Supposed to have an evil fucking deck. You might know him, actually. He's a witcher.
Yeah. Okay, so that's the... At this point... There we go! Thank you so much! I got Geralt of Rivia. I think I still need Triss Merigold in my deck, but I'm happy with the way things are going on right now. So I'm not going to take care of, obviously I don't have a choice, but to put a pin on this for a while and then continue the rest of the game. So let's see what else can we do. Can we take care of this? And do we have any contracts? Contracts can wait. How about we do have to take care of the scavenger hunts, right? So why don't we mix and match, and why don't we actually take care of the scavenger hunts? We do have to get, okay, we'll be going to Kaer Morhen at some point, okay? So we will probably, yeah, start with this, and let's take care of, okay, both of them are very, very far. Okay, so let's proceed with getting ourselves the Witcher gear. Where exactly are we going? There's one here, out of middle of nowhere, and the other one is here, out of middle of nowhere. Okay, so let's get started. Let's go and take care of this section first, and then we'll come back. All right, I'm back here. We're going to proceed with the quest. I put a temporary marker so I know where to exactly go. We are going now. So just for you guys, just so you know, we are here in the middle of nowhere, and yeah, we are here at the refugees camp, and we'll be going towards south to tackle obviously one, probably two undiscovered locations. Let's proceed. We are taking a break from the main quest because I don't want to rush into the main quest if we can help it, because the side contracts and side missions are also extremely, extremely interesting. And it's very, very useful as well, because you're not only going to get some good loot and stuff, you're also going to get some good experience for it. So, okay, there you go. There's something. And remember, I did change my difficulty level to, what was that difficulty level? Not the blood and, I think it's the blood and bones. Yeah, blood and bones, blood and broken bones. I didn't change it to, what was that last level difficulty? Oh my God, these people. Dude, I should have. Oh my God, what the heck? Oh, whoa, what happened? I know that stupid pieces are gonna explode, so I need to be careful. I don't want to. It's not a good example of the difficulty level, because these guys are level 7, and I'm at level what, 20, 21 or something. So obviously, these people are not a real example of how difficult it is, but I think we will come across equal level difficulties when we actually explore a bit more. Then we, why did I ever pick hatchet? No, okay. The ball, loot. There are also some other people right over here, because they're level 7. I didn't really mind applying the hangman's oil to. See, pirate leaders are all, they are just, what are you trying to do? Just get me my, there you go, that's what. And I also forgot, wait a minute, I forgot to show you the end of the last episode. I just realized, if you go back to the alchemy section, and we fought Catacan and got its decoction, I mean mutagen. We got Catacan's mutagen, so we are going to use Catacan. Okay, Chimera. Look at the Chimera's decoction. Damage dealt to force regenerates vitality. That is going to be extremely, extremely. The one that I like the most is Echidna. Look at the Echidna. Performing actions that consume stamina. Which every time you use a sign, gonna let you get your health back, so that is gonna be one pretty awesome decoction. We're gonna have to wait obviously for that, and we're also going to brew the short decoction. So now, while we are at it, let's talk about our character at the moment, right? And we have only one perk left, one available. So I, because we are planning on getting more and more potions, so acquired tolerance. So I'm going to use acquired tolerance or heightened tolerance. So I'm going to apply this to high acquired tolerance. So that would mean that it increases my number of so let me quickly check my character build and see. Wait, what? How do I, should I go to the inventory and see? Yeah, there we go. Toxicity is at the moment right now 37%. So out of, and if you look at the potions, right, your total toxicity of 230 right now. So this one is actually going to be 70. So I can use both the water hag decoction as well as echidna decoction, so that, oh sorry, not the echidna, chimera decoction, so that I'll keep gaining my health when I actually start causing damage to others. So that's about it.
Might want to look around some.
Please tell me there aren't any more enemies. I've already taken care of all of them. And oh, there you go. I should have. Okay. Oh, I only got one equipment out of that. Fine. Okay, we are going. Before we go, I'm gonna meditate. And remember, since we increase the difficulty, meditating is not going to give you health back. It's only going to replenish your alchemic ingredients, but your health remains the same. If you lower your difficulty level, then if you meditate, then it will also upgrade your health. It is going to replenish your health. Oh, what? Why did I ever remove that? Okay. What the heck, Roach? Why couldn't I? Okay, there you go. Now I can climb on it. That's strange. Okay, so where are we going next? Oh, I can still take care of this bandit camp. Okay, maybe I'll get a fast travel point there. Okay, oops, let me point that. Let me go to the bandit camp and then clear that area. Maybe then I can get a fast travel point. From there on, I can move on. Okay, so let's proceed. It's only 55 meters. Oh, okay.
Not so fast, Roach.
Okay, well, it's not going to give me any fast travel point, but I still have to loot. Rugged saddlebags, is that what I got? Because I came here. I should have come here as soon as I was in this area, because then I would have cleared this and I would have gotten that pirate leader's notes. Really? Is that going to give me a quest? Nope. Okay. There's nothing else here. Oh, whoa. Just explore, buddy. Don't be in a hurry. What's so hurry? Just try to explore this area and try to get stuff like this. See, you'd have missed out on master armor's repair kit. What's so hurry? Huh? What's so rush? Kalantine. I don't know why I picked that up. Oh, I'm an idiot. Okay, let's get started. Let's get out of here. And okay, this was what I was worried about. If I just use an igni right here right now, the explosion is going to kill me, because I'm not in a combat, so it's going to cause tremendous amount of damage. So is there any path for me? Okay, it's blocked. Okay, so is there anything else that I can, what the heck? Oh, there you go, master armor's repair kit. Get on that top of that, Geralt, please. Oh, what the heck? Climb. That's the one thing we Geralt Witcher game needs to improve upon. Parkouring. Burst. Look at that. Very, very unstable piece of shit. See, he couldn't climb this section. See, he couldn't even stand on the barrel. Why? Because there's clearly a way for me to go on top of that. Am I stuck here? Perfect. Okay. Am I stuck here? Come on, get up. Please tell me I'm not stuck here. Walk slowly. Oh my god, game, Geralt. Okay. I need to get out of this area quickly before I have to see more and more stupid things like this. Okay, well, we're gonna see you on the other side. Alright, we're continuing our adventure to finish up the scavenger quest. We are at the Inn of the Crossroads. I'm calling my horse. My horse doesn't want to come get inside with me, so let's okay, it's still struggling to find out where I am. Okay, let's go. Did I just see a big, huge building of some sort? What is that building? Look at the building right across. It's a huge tower. Maybe it's Nullgrad, I don't know. I'm gonna see. I'm facing in that direction of the building. So that building is obviously yeah, that's Novigrad, all right. So if you go straight, you're gonna go to Novigrad. Okay. Why is it pointing towards the back? Is it because it's on the other side of the bank? Is it really that? I'm going back, all right. Okay, yeah. Yeah, I need to go from behind and then meet that area. Fine.
Go.
Fine, game, you won. So I'm going to finish this one part. I'm going to extend this episode a bit because we're not doing any story. We're just exploring. Okay, don't go through the fog because you can find foglets over there. Like I said, I'm not exploring. Okay, dude, there isn't anything for you there. So I'm not going to stop and say hi to you because I've already cleared that area. I don't have a reason to try that again. So see you around, buddy. Have a good life. Good, meaningless, stupid life. And what is this? Are there monsters or are faster? They yeah, there are neckers, but really, why would I have to stop if there is nothing there? Not an undiscovered location, neither a fast travel point. Why would I want to stop and take care of... Oh my god, look at the bird. I think it's time to do a save because I don't want to be killed by a bird. So let's save the game and then now see if that bird is... Whether that bird is of a... several levels higher. I hope not, because this quest is not several levels higher.
Might want to look around some.
But again, I'm playing at a slightly higher difficulty, so obviously I need to be careful about trying to entice that bird into trying to attack me. Wait, do I see some kind of an underground cavern of some such? No, right? Oh, okay. I'm going away from it. Okay. That bird is causing a lot of distraction for me. I think they were eaten by this bird. But again, that bird is causing a lot of distraction for me. Right at this... Okay, there you go. Like I said. Forktail. Okay. Oh, fine. You're only level 15, I think. Not bad. Everything is critical. Probably because of my special silver sword, everything seemed to be critical here. Oops. I knew that you're gonna hit me. That's why folktales. Wait, did I not come across folktale before? That's interesting. Okay, now that is dead, I can peacefully explore this area to find the missing boots diagram update without worrying anything, because that piece of shit was flying across and I didn't know when it was going to swoop down. So now I can peacefully explore this area without nary... What the stupid piece of shit, where is that? I'm exploring this area like a madman and not finding out where exactly the chest would be. On the top side, nothing is shining. I'm going away from it. There has to be the chest, right? Oh, there you go. Okay. Fine, I found it. Yippee, hooray! No, I'm not going to go to the Skellige yet. So there's the other part of the treasure hunt, right? Where's the... yeah, there you go. We need to still find the Silver Sword and Gauntlets updates. all of them are very, very, very far away from where we are right now. So maybe I can find a fast travel point nearby, because we are in the middle of nowhere. So maybe this one would give us some kind of fast travel point. How about that? Let's try to explore that, and let me put this sword away. And hopefully there isn't any more birds that show up, or the creatures that show up, monsters that fly. Let's get out of here. It is dark, though it's 1 p.m. That's strange. It's so freaking dark. Obviously it's raining, but that shouldn't be the reason.
Slow now.
So this is... These are not bandits, these are soldiers, so let's not try to steal anything in front of them. Okay. Hey there. There is also another question mark, right? Undiscovered location, what was that? Yeah, here. Maybe I can find a fast travel point here, because I'm sure the game is not going to be that cruel, right? It's going to let you find some fast travel points every now and then. New marker. Yeah, there you go. Guarded treasure, at least. You have a marker, all right, which means that... Okay, I need to be careful. I don't know what is gonna... What's blocking it. Maybe a water hag or a grave hag. Which shouldn't pose us... Oh, bilge hag. It shouldn't... Yeah, 15... Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa! Jackass! Okay, no. I forgot. I'm not... Oh my god. There you go. I wanted to do this. I forgot that these guys are... Okay, done. Venom extract. Do call water hag to... Yeah, it is a water hag. Oh, wait. The name is Bilge Hag. Black Unicorn and Knight Gauntlets. Okay, Black Unicorn. That sounds good. That really sounds good, but... Art intensity. Look at that. Look at my sword. Although it has lower damage, look at the... Perks. Critical hit damage bonus. 48% and a chance to increase it. So if it keeps increasing the chance, look at the damage that I wrought in one hit. So no, thank you very much. I'm going to keep the black unicorn with me. I'm not going to sell it, at least at this moment right now. Maybe I'll dismantle it to get the parts, but thank you very much. My headhunter seems to be in perfect working condition. Thank you very much. So there we haven't... Did we get the fast travel point? It says marker, right? Oh, maybe it's a boat. Maybe it's a harbor. That's what I wanted to say. Maybe it's a harbor that got the marker. And I don't find a boat. I don't have a boat. Can I use this boat? No, it's not usable. So, fine. So let me go. What's the next location? How far is it? Is there anywhere near? Oh my god. I'm nowhere near this. What about the other? Where is the other location? Oh my god. Look at that. So I need to start with byways. You know what? It means that it's going to take a while. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop this episode right here, right now. And next time when we come back, we'll continue with our scavenging hunt quests. And then we might think about the races that we see, right? The derby, whatever that piece is. That's the first thing we're going to take care of. Not this one. This one can wait. This one. The race, right? We'll take care of the race. And that should be the plan. Once we take care of the races and we take care of the second part of scavenging hunt, the 23rd will wait until we get to level 23. So we are in no rush. Then we'll go to Skellige. So that should be the plan. Okay, thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this episode, please don't forget to click like and also subscribe to my channel. Click on the bell icon to get notified for any more updates on the Witcher game and other games as well. As you can see, there's also live streaming on Assassin's Creed Origins that show up every now and then. And every now and then an actor also shows up. Anyways, thank you so much, guys. Have a good day. Take care. Bye-bye. This is Ravi signing off.